If you're a parent or a coach and your kids are in soccer or football or something like that, you probably have a lot of things to manage. Who's responsible for the orange slices, or who's responsible for what uniform to wear this weekend? So how do you manage all that? Well, TeamSnap has the solution, and we're gonna see it right now. Who are you?
I'm Ken McDonald, Vice President of Customer Acquisition at TeamSnap, and I've been involved in technology for about 20 years, pretty much every role you can imagine in a startup. And probably more relevant to this position, I also am a coach. I've coached kids in basketball for many years, from ages 3 on up.
Hoops. Yeah. Yay.
Exactly.
So what does TeamSnap do? And first of all, is it a free app? Tell me what it is.
So it's an online service that lets you manage your team or group. And our focus has definitely been on youth sports. And certainly the sweet spot has even been kids aged 8 to 13 who've really got a lot of logistics around their teams. It's a freemium model, so there's a base version with a base set of features that's free, and it's got advertising, and then you can get more features and no ads if you pay a minimal amount a month, basically $8 to $16 a month for the entire team. And since the team's got about 15 people on it, works out to about 50 cents to a dollar a team, or I'm sorry, per player.
Yeah, my dad used to be an AYSO soccer coach.
For, yeah, exactly.
The rest of the world calls it football, right? Only in America, we make our own rules up for things. But, you know, they had two uniforms, if I remember right. They had parents' clubs. They had, you know, like the orange slices and the drinks for after the game. And then somebody would always take us to a restaurant, right? Is that what it helps you
do? That's exactly the types of things. And, you know, particularly from the parent standpoint, one of the things that we hear from people a lot is, hey, I've got 2-3 kids. They're each involved in a couple activities, sometimes concurrently. And especially as the kids get older, there's, you know, one or more activities pretty much every day. And just trying to keep track of where I got to be and what the kids need to be wearing and what I've paid and what I haven't paid for, all that kind of stuff, it's just a real pain in the butt. And we've tried to solve that problem with a very easy to use app.
Yep, and it's a mobile app on Android and iPhone?
Yep, it runs on both of those, and then if you want, you can still use it on the web, but most people are on the mobile app because frankly they're out on the soccer field, the ice rink, you know, basketball court, et cetera.
Or on the way there, and I always remember, what field are we going to?
That comes up a lot. And actually, you know, if you want, I can show you.
Let's see it.
So, you know, this is the home screen. You got access to all of your teams. And one of the things that comes up, you know, we've been talking a lot about it, is the schedule. That is certainly one of the core parts of the application here. It shows you your upcoming practices, your game, and then all the details about those. So like for the game, you can get a map and jump right into navigation. Makes it really easy for parents. They don't even have to think about where they're going so much. Tells them when the game's going to be. This is really important. The parents or the players will indicate whether they're going or they're not going, and they can add comments about, you know, hey, I'm going to be there, but I'm going to be late, and I'm going to come back to that in a bit. What time they got to be there? As we talked about before, the uniforms. Who's bringing the refreshments? So Andy Richardson's bringing the orange slices this week, and then, you know, there's a couple of key things out of this schedule. So one is you can subscribe to the team calendar. So if you've got your personal calendar and say Gmail, you can pull in the team events, and as the coach or team manager is changing the schedule, those changes are reflected here. So here you can see this is my personal a Google Calendar. On the left is a company event, on the right is that team event that got pulled in from TeamSnap, And again, if the coach or team manager changes it, it's going to change there.
That's cool.
And then, you know, the other thing, and this is really saves a lot of headaches for the coach, is because the parents and players are RSVPing, it shows here who's coming, who's not coming, and who's maybe, and then comments about it. Usually there's like all these emailing back and forth about who's coming and not, and it'd be very stressful for the coach to know, do I have enough people to play, or maybe I've got enough players, but I don't have like a key position filled, like I don't have a goalie, I don't have a pitcher, something like that. And this just resolves all that stress for the coach and really cuts down enormously on all that back and forth.
Yeah.
So that's the scheduling. There's some other things. Certainly, the roster is a big deal. You know, the ability right from the field to be able to call people or look up information. You know, Johnny's on your team and you're at a soccer tournament and he's wandered off.
I see the phone number there for this person, which I'm sure they appreciate that in public.
Yeah, these are just made up things, but you know, here's mom's number, and you know, you can just call mom, right? You know, from, hey, why is Johnny not back? You
does
know,
that integrate into the contact on your phone as well?
You can absolutely do that. Okay. Yep, you can import them right into,
because that's always useful, because very few people keep all their contacts up to date on their phone. Modern people do, but my dad, I always have to go, hey, how come you didn't update this person's phone number?
Absolutely, absolutely. And the nice part here is, you know, I mean, a lot of kids, they've got half a dozen different people that are involved with care in their family. You know, it might be, you know, a stepdad, it might be a nanny, it might be grandma, grandpa. And here, all those people can update their data, and it's not the coach who's got to try and maintain one list. It's all kind of updated by the team. You know, and the coach can get it, or other players on the team can use it to try and set up a carpool, you know, who lives near me, that kind of stuff.
That's cool.
And then that information then gets used, a lot of times from the coach or the team manager, but they can send an email directly from here. So again, they're on the field and something comes up, you know, and just pop in and grab everybody's information.
Johnny broke his leg, we're on the way to the hospital.
Well, if that comes up, then instead of emailing, that's where you'd use the SMS,
yeah,
right? And this one comes up a lot with just, hey, there's lightning, the game's canceled. Or, you know, I actually had a very personal example of this. My son's team, they were on the way to a basketball tournament, and they had a case. The coach went up early and he ran into just awful traffic due to construction. He pulled to the side of the road, he used this feature, he texted everybody on the team, said, take side roads. They ended up, everybody got there like just in the nick of time, and they ended up winning that tournament. They would have forfeited without this feature, which obviously would have been a real downer for the kids there.
That's a feature request. Waze integration, right? Because Waze routes me around all the traffic.
Absolutely. I mean, that you know, you could definitely.
And some of these new apps, by the way, like Glimpse or Waze, are showing you can show your friends where you actually are, so you can explain why you're late because you're stuck in traffic. You know, last night there was a big wreck.
That's a great idea for a future version. We'll definitely. I'm going to see when it pops into Google Maps and does navigation, it tells you that, but it doesn't bring that back into the app and say leave now.
Or Life 360 does that with a family group, lets you watch where your kids all are so you know where they are. You know?
Yeah, yeah. That could be good for soccer tournaments when the kids wander away and don't come back. Yeah, exactly.
Where do they go?
Go ahead.
So this is it's an app on your phone. It helps coaches. Does the coach see something different than the parents would or the kids would on their phones?
You know, most of the interface is the same. The coach certainly gets additional capabilities, and this coach can decide what they want people on the team to be able to do. I want people on my team to be able to email either each other. I want them to be able to see this kind of information, that kind of stuff. But it's mostly meant to be, again, depending on how restrictive the coach wants, it's mostly meant to be a sharing tool across the entire team where everybody has access to everything that's going on.
Does it have a way to reserve resources? You know, like with soccer, you need to make sure you have field time, right? So does it help you talk to the people who run the fields?
Not that at this time. That's a whole other topic and getting into some of those bigger organizations and so forth. That's a longer topic.
How did you guys start this company? Why did you pick this kind of thing?
You know, some of the founders were guys who did web design by day, and they had a bunch of teams that they managed, and it was just one of those things where they were like, boy, it is a real pain to manage these teams. You know, why don't we put together what we do during the day to try and solve our problem at night? And, you know, it was one of those things where they were trying to solve their own problem. They weren't even thinking about it, you know, initially about it as a business. And then it sort of came to them in that process of, you know, there might be a real business here. And then somebody brought up, well, you know, there's 30 million teams a year, teams or groups that are organized. There's actually a heck of a lot of people who are going through the same experience that you are. And yeah. That's when the light bulbs really started to go off.
How did you start getting known? Because, you know, because you're competing with Excel and email, right?
That's exactly who the competition is. And it remains still the competition is
so
is
how do you get to be known as, you're on this team, you got to get this app?
Well, the first couple of years, it was just word of mouth. And it really spread very quickly. I mean, we picked up 500,000 users before we really did much in the way of marketing. And a lot of that is just, if you save people time, at the end of the season, they go to the next team that they're on, and if it's just being run through email and Excel, somebody will raise their hand and say, there's a better way to do this. And so they'll bring that over from the other team. And because the kids from your soccer team tend to be different kids, you know, all scattered at different teams in the next season, you have this natural spreading that just happens. Since then, we've in the last 2.5 years, as we started to raise some money, we've started to do more traditional online marketing, and we just particularly focus on people who are very into sports. People are looking up baseball coaching drills. That's probably a pretty good target for our product.
Yeah. Are you thinking of doing any video integration? Because I got pitched by another company that helps coaches video their matches, and then have a UI that lets them really go fast through the plays to get to visualize what went wrong or what was good on the play.
We don't have any video in yet. We do have a number of companies that we've spoken with that we're doing some or having some discussions with about some ways that we could work together and integration, and some of those are companies that we definitely recommend when people need a video solution. But it is a topic that has come up a lot is, you know, should we have some video integration right into the product?
You know, I'm sure everybody's...
Photos we do have, actually.
Oh,
you know, obviously a lot of people have a photo solution of some sort. You know, they use some online photo sharing site or,
probably,
you know, Facebook or,
yeah,
you know,
Instagram.
What have you. But
look at my cute kid scoring the goal. I see that on Facebook
exactly.
all the
but
time.
Exactly. The problem is that not everyone on your team is necessarily your friend on Facebook. And if you're on Shutterfly or something like that, not everybody is necessarily on Shutterfly or has access to your photos. So we do have a central repository of all the team photos, and it allows everybody on the team to upload the photos, download the photos, share them up to Facebook, all those kinds of things. And it gets quite a bit of usage within the app.
Yeah. Tell me about the company. Was it wholly funded by this web design company and bootstrapped, or did you guys take venture funding?
So at this point, we have taken some venture funding. The, you know, the early days of the company, there were a couple of rounds, largely angels, a seed round from Trinity Ventures. You know, our main funding, we just, it was about 5 months ago, took on a $7.5 million round that was led by the Foundry Group. We also have some money from the parent company for the Toronto Star. We have a very big presence in Canada, and they wanted to get involved with the company. And then we have some other investors like Harris Barton, you know, former NFL player from this area who's got a fund that who's put in some money. So it's sort of a mix of different companies, and it's, you know, about $12 million and change that it's gone into the company at this point.
Are you thinking of doing anything else with the technology and, you know, maybe making a calendar app for enterprises or something like that? Or Or are you going to stay wholly focused on sports?
We're focused on teams and groups, you know, and we've talked about mostly youth sports here, but I mean, there's a couple things. First, actually, we've got people who use it who, you know, we've got kids teams that are 3 years old up to adult teams. We actually have a fairly big adult team population. There was the founders actually set it up for adult teams, and it was originally almost all adult teams. But we also have quite a few groups. We just don't, you know, we haven't, because we're a relatively small company, we haven't focused on it as much, but we have a lot of Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, we have faith-based groups.
I imagine teachers are using it in other places that you probably didn't predict, right?
Absolutely.
You know, we actually have my track coach was the history teacher as well. So, and they always took field trips. Yeah. So I would imagine that this is great for field trips too. It's the same thing. You know, a list of parents, a list of kids, and somebody has to drive.
There's a lot of ways that you can use it. Yeah, we actually have a couple of fire departments that use it. And the reason they do is they put in their training schedule, and then everybody subscribes to that on their Google Calendar. They use the email and the text to know, you know, let people know when there's something really critical going on that they need to, you know, show up for this training session. But, you know, it's just to manage a lot of the logistics around the firehouse. I mean, and again, we haven't focused on that, but it is a wide range of things that people have done with it. You know, we do have, and again, we've talked about this more at the level of the individual team or group. We do also have a solution that is for clubs and leagues, where a club could say, geez, I've got, you know, 50 or 100 teams. I want all of them involved. And then, you know, I'm going to have a master calendar. I'm going to have a master website for the whole group. And I'm going to have registration so people can pay their registration fees for the upcoming soccer season, those kinds of things. You know, that's kind of been our first major foray out of the individual team and group area.
Yeah. Anything else we need to know about it? Because it's pretty straightforward.
Probably the biggest thing is just, you know, we've got, at this point, we've made a lot of progress. We've got 7 million people using it in 195 countries. And the last 2 months, it's been used 50 million times a month. So it's really, you know, and yet we still have only got about 1% penetration into the market. So we sort of look forward and we go, there's a lot of room to grow, and email is pretty easy to competitor to compete with. So
yeah, that's great. Where do we get it?
You just go to www.teamsnap.com to get started and set up your team or group.
And I bet you can search in the Play Store or the iTunes Store, right?
Absolutely, you can get started there too. There are certain things on setting up a team that, you know, probably a little easier on the web, but the apps are, you know, in the app stores are a good place to start too.
Very cool. Thank you so much for coming on the show to me.